need to go bananas for Holly Zimfrochek.
Welcome to Dynamite PDX, guys. This happens pretty much every single Saturday night at 9:30, where we showcase improv. Sometimes we have stand-up, and then sometimes we can have some sketch happening. But tonight you're going to be seeing some amazing improv groups. You're going to see House Team Battle Axe. And then those amazing boys, Broke Grammy! Based off of your suggestions. So let's get you a little bit warmed up to yell some stuff out. Tonight I saw some friends from my hometown of Albuquerque, New Mexico. Yeah. So on the count of three, I want you to yell your hometown. One, two, three! Whoa, was something? Okay, never mind. And then I also had a delicious dinner of a tamale from my home state. So what is a famous dish that you like to eat from your home state? One, two, three. What was that back there? Clam chowder. Oh, is that a Massachusetts or a Maine thing? I don't want to screw it up. Okay, yeah, claiming it. The red or the white? Is there a red clam chowder?
White,
okay. Okay, cool. So let's go ahead and get this started off. Team that is near and dear to my heart, Battle Axe! Yeah!
Hey everybody, how's it going? Oh,
yeah. Woo, woo, let's hear it!
Yeah! Too bad. Woo, woo, let's hear it! Good. We're Battle Axe and we're just gonna do some improv for you guys and gals. So, to get this started, can we get a word, something that you, maybe something that you lost and you desperately want to find? A hat? Or does it say a cat? A hat? What kind of hat?
This is a knit yarn hat.
Oh, a knit hat. Did someone that you know knit it?
No.
Okay, that's great. So, a knitted hat.
A knitted hat.
Thank you. Looks good.
Bro, I'm not feeling it. It's like it's warm, but do I need to be that warm?
Well, if you're gonna turn heads this summer, you gotta have a warm hat, Trent.
I'm trying to turn heads this summer, but I'm thinking like it's knit too. Whoa. What if I wear it like on my head, but off my head?
Kind of like a half-cocked hat?
Yeah.
Welcome to Yarn About.
Sorry, what was that?
Welcome to Yarn About It. Yarn About It.
Yarn About It. Yarn means like to spin a story. So it's like each hat has a story.
No, just my hats are made of yarn.
Oh, okay.
We're looking for something to turn some heads. I was thinking of a scarf. He's going for more of a knitted hat.
Oh, I like all of that on both of you. You should buy it all. All of the stuff.
Listen.
In the... Yes.
Marjorie?
That is what, I knitted that myself.
Fancy.
I don't usually read cursive, so this is a new thing for me.
Well, it's really hard to cursive knit, but I discovered it. I have a lot of really amazing things I've done with yarn. Would you like to see some of the things I've done with my yarn?
Holy hell yes!
Oh, this is my cat mitten.
Oh, wow.
He's stiff. Because he is fully made of yarn. But there's really a cat in there.
What about this baby?
That's a baby.
That's just a regular baby. Okay,
don't shake the
baby. Don't shake the baby. That's why I have him covered in yarn.
Seems fair.
So, I don't know what's up with Trent lately. He's been wearing a lot of really heavy knitted coats. And it's like August, so...
It's... Because he lost his virginity.
What?
Yeah.
He's wearing the yarn virginity coat?
Yeah. I mean, I couldn't tell you, because, you know, The yarn chastity belt needs to stay hidden, but mine's off. Trent and I did it.
Congratulations!
Thank you so much.
Oh my god!
So I was thinking, like, since neither one of us are virgins anymore, I got us these virgin wool coats.
Since we're not virgins anymore, we have virgin wool coats?
Yeah, it's irony.
Will you put mine on for me?
Oh, that is so dirty.
Oh,
oh, it feels so good.
Oh, it's itchy.
Yeah, it's itchy.
So, let's, like, hold hands.
Yeah.
And it's really stiff.
It's virgin.
Oh my god! Oh my god! Are you guys not virgins anymore? Oh no! Oh no!
Mom, I didn't want you to
find
out.
Oh no!
Just to watch.
They're just to look out at them, and now they're covered in yarn.
Yeah, covered in yarn.
I brought y'all some lemonade.
Oh,
watching kids can be exhausting.
Sure can. I'm parched.
I don't even know what to do, eat my sandwich or drink my lemonade or watch children.
Can't we do it all at the same time?
I feel really like I'm just doing too much.
Why are those weirdos looking at us through that window?
I don't know.
Donna, get the binoculars.
It's like they're just drinking lemonade.
I don't want to.
I brought y'all a pair of binoculars.
You're going to have to strap them to my eyeballs.
Put them on the eyeballs. It's exhausting watching these kids.
I'm so tired from watching these kids. I've been up for the last 8 years.
Are those binoculars?
Are they being tied to their faces?
They're looking back at us.
I think my binoculars are backwards.
Let's wait for them.
I'm sorry, you've been looking at y'all selves.
I was just looking at my eyeballs.
They look so tiny. I thought they would look bigger with binoculars.
I'm gonna flash them my mole.
Do it.
Oh, did I just see a mole?
Oh, it's like 3 dimensions.
I'm gonna show them my tattoo.
Oh, do it. The sailor one?
Yep.
Oh. Is that Popeye?
I don't know if my heart can take it.
I'm just so tired just looking at these children.
Let's go make love.
Oh,
let's take these.
After you.
Would you like another brandy, Brandon?
I think I would, baby.
All right, Brandon, I'll fix you another brandy.
Thanks, Brandy. I'll take another brandy.
Rocks or no rocks?
Yes, please.
one rock.
Brandy, you always know how to serve in my brandy.
Well, I hope so, Brandon. After you did brand me with marriage.
I just wanted to let you know that Braden is done with the brambles.
Thank you, Brandy.
Thank you, Brandon.
Brandy, Braden.
You know, I was thinking.
Yes, Brandy.
This next one, maybe we call him Brady.
Brady, or of a girl, Brenda.
Sure, or it could be Brady. For a boy or a girl.
Mom, Dad, there's a Breaking Bad marathon on. Can I watch it?
What do you think?
I don't know.
It's pretty bad.
Please.
He is begging.
We all know the TV's my babysitter.
It's true.
All right.
Thanks.
I love being married to you.
And are you, Brandy?
Oh, Brandon.
But Bernie there.
We just opened the same night. I was been running into the Brandy Pepper's breakfast fair.
He makes a good point.
We should go to bed.
I didn't take anything, Mom. I was just looking
For money?
Yeah, I was looking for money.
Why do you want money?
I want lunch. It costs money at school.
I understand that. I just thought I taught you better to make your own lunch. I provided a garden for you, a cow, a chicken.
Yeah, but none of the other kids are bringing raw milk and fresh kale.
Don't you want to stand out?
No, I don't.
Hey!
What?
You want some Lunchables? Yeah. I got some Lunchables. You want some Lunchables?
I do.
You want some Lunchables?
Yes.
I got the Lunchables right here. You want to give me some money for the Lunchables?
What if I traded you a
you got that raw milk?
I got some tempeh and a...
Did I hear some raw milks in there?
Yeah. You guys like raw milk?
Oh, yeah.
It is banned, I think. Here.
That's why we like it.
Well, we like anything banned.
But it's I got a shitload. I have a whole cow.
Did I just smell organic beets?
Yeah, they're dried, though.
Oh yeah, that's the best kind of dried beet.
I'll give you some fruit snacks for it.
Come on.
Right, do I hear the crackle of unpasteurized eggs?
Crackle?
Bart, you're so weird.
When they crackle together, they're more delicate than pasteurized eggs are.
Bart, don't you have like a toilet to clean or something?
Or like a chimney to sweep?
Get out of here!
Hey.
Yes is the answer to both those questions.
So how are the kids at school making funny accents?
Oh, Blimey, it's terrible.
You tell them you are proud to be from the UK.
I was worried for a moment you didn't remember where we were from.
Mammy, Peppy, I want to go play with Brendan and Brady and Brooking over by the brush. Why can't you be more like your brother, Bethany?
Blimey, Bethany! By golly! Don't do that then.
Cheerio. See, Bethany's more like a classic Brit. You got to appeal to the Americans, like, you know, UK sensibilities. You got to, like, talk about the Queen and all that.
Well, Hugh Grant, I'm not and never will be.
Did you just say the HG word in this household?
Holy God, I did.
You know how I feel about Hugh Grant?
Listen. Just because H.G. left you at the altar.
Yeah.
That's right, I said it. Doesn't mean You can't appreciate the beauty that is our love.
Son.
Yeah.
I'm so proud that you're so fond of your mother. I want you to direct that love elsewhere.
But where, mother? Where is love more purely?
Mommy, brother! There's an old man here says he knows you from way back. His name's Hugh Grant.
Well, hello, I'm Hugh Grant, and I'm hot as fuck even though I'm old.
Checks out to me.
Hugh, why did you leave me?
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to leave you. But I got signed to another project. I had to go or I would have lost all the money.
Hollywood!
It's a hard business.
You chose Hollywood over me!
I mean, damn, it's Hollywood, babe.
But I'm Margaret. No!
Margaret Atwood, the author. That's my mom.
I think I'm dying.
No! No, Hugh! You don't have consumption, do you? It's very contagious.
I have worms.
Worms. So I got worms, and I got menace. And I got tiny squid.
Okay.
Which are a delicacy in some countries.
I'm going to eat a fish with it.
Yep, here we use them as bait. Go figure.
That's what I came to the bait store for.
So you want worms or menace or tiny squid?
I want all three of them, and then I want them in a one bag. So it's like a surprise every time I reach in.
I'm going to give you the grab bag.
Ha! So what I want. I came in here. I'll give you four buttons.
I done told you the last time you come in here.
Let me use my buttons!
Look, I've even wrote a sign. Buttons is not currency.
Yeah, but then didn't you see the post-it that I will put on that? That said, accept you when I accept buttons. Shit.
Hey, y'all, welcome.
Shit.
Oh, hey, Willard.
Aw, fuck.
Willard, you seem real distraught.
She's always busting my balls about my buttons.
Well, maybe if you weren't trying to bust your buttons all about town, your balls would need to be busted for
free. Why don't people accept buttons as currency? I say if I can make paper currency, you should be able to make buttons. I just want some minutes with the worms and whatever the hell.
Tiny Smith.
Willard! Shit! What am I supposed to do with this bag of buttons?
Keep that right here, because Big Catfish Bill is mine.
Oh.
You come here to get Big Catfish Bill? You can't!
I was gonna get him. I was gonna finally get him.
You know that fish is mine to get?
That's not what I heard when I heard it.
I don't need fighting in my bait / video rental.
He got me some motherfucking minnows and squirms and other shit.
Oh!
Shit!
I hear Big Bill swimming! I just hear him swimming! I'm not even by the pond yet and I hear him swimming!
I'm gonna use these buttons if I have nothing else to use! Get out of my way!
Alright, Willard, I'm gonna watch you catch Big Bill with buttons, you big badass bitch!
Oh, just swimming along.
Son of a bitch! Give me some bait!
You know, you could attach those buttons to like a rod and reel instead of just flicking them at the fish.
Oh, look, some buttons! These look nice.
Wait! Big Bill's eating the buttons!
He's eating the buttons!
I don't think Big Bill can eat buttons. It gets stuck in his big GI track.
Oh, that doesn't feel too good.
Oh, he's struggling. He's struggling.
Oh, this could be my lucky day.
You catch this fish with buttons, I'm gonna goddamn kill myself.
Yes!
I'm free!
What the hell just happened?
Here's...
But you're gonna have to choose. I've got a scarf, and he's got a knitted hat.
Yeah, but I'm wearing it ironically because it's way too warm for a hat.
Yeah, my neck's sweating. Just my neck.
Did either of you make yours?
No, but I bought it at a place where somebody made it.
Marjorie.
Ooh, that's
hot. She was intense. She knitted a baby.
To be fair.
And a cat.
She didn't actually knit an entire baby or a cat. She just knitted around a baby and a cat.
Yeah. I picked it up and I was like, oh, it's a cute stuffed animal. It was a baby.
So, like, do you want to go out with me or do you want to keep talking about Marjorie?
Yeah, the first thing you said.
Yeah.
It's me.
Marjorie! Wait a minute. Did you knit her?
I knit a person.
Time. All we need to begin is a suggestion of a location that begins with a lowercase letter. Like a bathroom or a church, but not those.
Supermarket.
A supermarket.
Oh, yes. Thank you. Todd, I bought your cereal, all right? I bought the cereal that you wanted, all right?
Why can't I have my cookies too?
Because I'm only your stepmother, not your real mother. So I don't get to fairly decide how much sugar you get throughout the day.
I'm gonna start dieting next month, Veronica. Just let me have my fucking cookies. When I visit my mom, she lets me have the cookies that I want to have.
Right, and I can't wait till you visit your mom again. But unfortunately, you're with me for the next 6 weeks while your mom's off working in New York and your father is off working in Florida.
Yeah, my mom's a big Broadway actress.
I know, you don't have to remind me.
My dad's a dinner theater actor.
Your father works very hard and he's very talented, and Death of a Salesman is a very good play.
Yeah, he makes 1/10 of what my mom makes.
Okay.
That's soap dish, too. Kevin Kline's Death of a Salesman.
Yes,
I love
that movie.
Dinner Theater in Florida.
And Sally.
But now it's come to real life. It's really happening to Dad.
Okay, Todd, calm down, please.
Just give me the fucking snickerdoodle.
Please. I can't have another emotional breakdown in public, and I'm talking about my own. All right? I can't do it. I'm getting you soy milk. Because you could use some more feminine hormones running through your body. There's a lot of masculinity, aggression, popping out all over. And you know what I mean by popping out, right?
You're not supposed to see that.
It's fine. We're family.
Not really.
We are. For the next 6 weeks, we are family. You know, you could go and you could go do your thing here. You could. You don't have to follow me around.
I can go do my thing?
No, not that thing.
Not what I meant. They won't tell me the restroom code.
That's because your picture is hung
hung up in their break room.
Yeah, I have a reputation at this supermarket. Why would you marry a guy so much older than you?
It seemed like a good idea at the time. He was my professor and he made a lot of sense. And sometimes when someone is speaking Shakespeare to you and looking you in the eye, you can't help but feel like they wrote it themselves.
Well, obviously my dad didn't write Shakespeare.
I know. I know. I'm just trying to explain what falling in love feels like. It felt like your father had written me these sonnets that he was teaching me in class.
You know, that's how he wooed my mom, too.
I know. I didn't at the time, now I do, because you tell me every other hour.
He was pretty good with a sonnet, I gotta admit that. Can we get out of the produce aisle?
No, you need more fruit. You haven't pooped all week. And you're stinking up the house, okay?
Stop monitoring my poops, Veronica.
Well, if you would take better care of yourself, then I wouldn't have to.
I'm fine.
Avocados are a good fat.
Here. I like them in guacamole.
Fine.
But they're gross when they're by themselves. Mash them up, put some salt and jalapenos and fucking lime juice in there. They give me a shload of chips and I'm fine.
It's not. That's a made up word, Todd.
You know who made up words? Shakespeare. He made up like half the words in the English language. Didn't even exist before he came into being.
All right, good.
If he really was a person.
I'm not having the Shakespeare argument with you again, Tom. I'm not doing it, okay? I'm not going to have a nervous breakdown in the middle of the supermarket today.
All I'm saying, it must have been Christopher Marlowe. Oh yeah, hell yeah. Can we get a case of the pamplemousse?
No.
I want a case of pamplemousse LaCroix. Otherwise, I'm just going to drink soda. Give me LaCroix, it's healthy.
You know that I fear that we're drinking so much LaCroix that one day soon somebody's gonna have done a scientific test and say there's lots of cancer in those things. Because that's what happens with all these things, right?
I don't care because they taste hella good.
All right, we have a long, long summer ahead of us.
Three fortnights.
I got a new job.
I did.
All right.
I'm just warning you, I'm going to give you my 30 days notice any day now.
Well, honestly, Trisha, you've, I mean, you've tried your best, but you haven't been great here.
I love it when you say sweet things to me.
Well, you've showed up late for most of your shifts, so...
Thank you.
And, you know, your break ended 5 minutes ago. You really, we need a cashier at ILO.
I know, but you came in here knowing that my break was over. Just to spend time with me, I'm sure. I'm going to give you my notice any second now.
You can give me your notice now, Trisha. What's the new job?
Mr. Myers.
Please call me Ted.
Teddy.
Just call me Ted.
I like Teddy.
Nobody calls Teddy. Me Teddy.
My new job starts with a B. Okay, guess.
You're a barista.
Yes! Yes! Oh my god, you're so smart.
Well, I'm an assistant manager at a supermarket, so... yeah, that would stand to reason.
Would you like some more coffee? I'll practice making it for you.
Yeah, I'll just have some black coffee.
Please. Okay, I just poured it for you. I'm gonna be a really good barista, Teddy.
So, just Ted, please.
Okay, Theodore.
So is it the Starbucks? So I guess we'll still be seeing a lot of each other.
I quit. Just kidding, I'm giving you my notice.
Okay, well,
giving you 30 days notice.
I don't need 30 days, 2 weeks is fine.
I'm giving you 60 days notice. Don't try to stop me!
Honestly, Trisha, you've had problems with the machines. You've let underage people buy alcohol. And...
That was such a great story.
Well, it's not a great story. It's criminal, and we can get fined.
But now they have a good story to tell everyone. See, I'm touching people's lives in a positive way.
We ID 40 and under here, so anybody who looks 40 and under, you should be carded.
Okay.
In the next 2 weeks.
In the next 6 months. I'm giving you my 6 months notice.
Look, I'll talk to Raheem at Starbucks, and you can get started right away, you know.
You are so nice to me, but don't be stupid. We can spend more time together first. Did you get the note I left in your car? Did Mrs. Myers get the note I left on
Mrs.
your car?
Myers got the note, yes. Yeah, I'm,
Now that's a story.
Yes, it is a story.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
And it doesn't... I had to explain that I have a young employee with, I'm gonna say, a crush.
Thank you!
An unrequited crush.
If only I understood what unrequited meant.
Well, it means not requited. It means not returned.
Oh my gosh, it's like poetry coming out of your mouth right now. Are you saying a love sonnet to me right now?
This isn't Shakespeare, Tricia. This is, this can't...
You love me.
Nope.
You love me?
No.
I think you were getting tripped up because you were trying to say you love me. So your DNA is in my body.
I'm going to talk to Raheem and get you started at Starbucks right away. And, you know, if you're qualified to be a barista, you know, you don't have to work right here.
Yeah, I do.
No, you don't.
Yeah, I do. Because you know why? Because I said so.
Okay, can you get to aisle 3 and start checking out some customers?
Sure. Watch me walk over there.
All right, I don't want that coffee anymore, Trisha.
I think you want it. If you take a drink of it, it means you love me.
And ask for 2 custom-built sandwiches. That's special. That's a break from the routine. Normally, I get the sandwiches that were made yesterday and pre-wrapped.
Philip, you used a coupon to buy these sandwiches. You got a 2-for-1.
Don't you love me for my frugality?
Well, I did. My feelings are hurt. You could have done a little better. I wanted to go to Ox. That's a real place.
I know what Ox is.
It's delicious.
Well, it's too fancy.
Oh.
We don't deserve that.
Oh.
You get a perfectly good Italian sub. Mortadelle.
Don't you sweet talk me.
Mortadelle, don't salam.
Don't you dare. Don't pretend like we're in Italy all of a sudden.
Mortadel, salam, capicol? Gabagool?
No.
Mozzarella?
Stop. You shut up.
Well, if you don't want your sandwich, I'll eat it.
No, I don't want you to eat my sandwich. I'll eat my own sandwich, Philip, just like I'll make my own bed, just like I'll give birth to my own children. Which I did.
Yes, you
eight
did.
Eight times.
You were an optimum. Not all at once, but... spread out over a 12-year period. Look, the day's not over yet. How do you know that this is the culmination of our anniversary? Maybe I'm just getting warmed up.
Well, you told the Uber, you said, drop us off here and pick us up in a half hour. So my expectations are low.
Well, got changed with the times, though. Took an Uber.
I asked you to take a lift because Uber supports Trump.
How do they do that?
What?
How does Uber support Trump?
I don't know. I read it online. Don't,
can't believe everything you read online.
I can't believe everything you read online.
I don't read anything online. I get three newspapers every morning.
And you read them all, and it makes me sick.
Look, this is the golden anniversary.
Don't tell me how old I am. I know how old I am.
78.
Stop telling me. Don't even think it. I can tell when you're thinking things.
Look, you understand everything about me, Esmeralda. We've been together for most of our lives.
I know how long.
You see right into my soul.
And it makes me sick.
You sure you're not gonna eat that?
I don't give a shit about this sandwich anymore. All I wanted was a fancy dinner. At OX. And you couldn't even give me that. As a matter of fact, I wrote you a whole letter saying that's all I wanted. Did you get my letter?
When did you send it?
I put it on your pillow, you stupid idiot.
Well, I didn't see it, no.
Well, what? How could you?
I don't look for notes. I don't put notes on my pillow.
All right, if you're pretending like you're having a heart attack right now, like the last time, and we got into an argument in the supermarket.
It wasn't pretending.
It was pretending.
No.
We got to the hospital and they said, no blockage.
Well, it felt real. That's all that matters.
Do you love me, Philip?
Been together for 50 years.
Okay, that none of that said yes or no. None of those words. None of them.
We have eight beautiful children together.
Well, some of them are cute.
Well, yeah, we have six beautiful children. And Dan.
And the eighth one.
Yes. Eat your gabagool.
I don't give a shit about the gabagook.
You gotta watch what you say.
The gabagook. The gabagook.
Gabagook.
Stop trying to flirt with me, Philip.
You know it works when I speak Italian.
Yes, maybe a little bit.
Remember where we honeymooned?
Italy.
Little Italy, yeah.
Have your hot flash or something?
I think so, Todd. I think so.
It's because you miss my dad.
Yes, I miss your father very much. He's been gone, what, 6 hours? And it has been very difficult, very challenging so far.
You guys have been doing cyber while he's in Sarasota?
Say that sentence again.
You guys gonna be doing cyber when he's in Sarasota. Are you going to take a lover?
I'm not taking a lover, Todd.
Fine.
You don't need any more candy. Let's just wait in the checkout line.
Halloween's in 2 months. We're gonna stock up.
They put all of this candy here because they're just trying to get you to purchase it at the last second. Feel like you need it.
Who cares? I love maple nut goodies.
Hey, Todd. I feel like we should sign you up for camp.
What kind of camp?
Well?
Fat camp?
If that's what you want, but I would never make you. You could do tennis camp, or swimming camp, or Boy Scout camp.
What about theater camp?
Do you really want to be like your father?
I'd like to be like my mom, be on Broadway. I've got a great tenor voice.
Oh yeah, let me hear it.
What do you want to hear me sing?
I just said let me hear it, so it doesn't matter. If I wanted something
specific.
Gotta
narrow down the parameters, though.
No, if I wanted something specific, I totally would have said, let me hear this thing. Okay, fine. Let me hear the solo from Rigoletto.
All right, fine, you win.
Maybe we can find a nice girl for you to hang out with this summer.
What do you mean, hang out with? You trying to pimp me out, Veronica?
All right.
Everybody at school is disgusted by me, okay?
Oh, come on. That can't be true.
It's totally true.
You're not disgusting. You're just a little sweaty.
I've seen 5 specialists, and they all say they don't know why I'm constantly sweating.
Well, it could just be growing pains, you know? Like, when I was going through puberty, I had a pretty good childhood.
I bet you did. You had great skin. I'm a pizza face.
No, you're not. Aw, Todd, I'm not a pizza face. Sure, you've got some acne, but, you know, we could put some makeup on that.
Makeup?
Yeah.
All right, I'm willing to try anything.
Wait, did we just agree on something?
Did we? Give me some fucking maple nut goodies. What are you doing?
Putting another note on your car.
No, Tristan, you can just tell me. Just tell me.
I love you.
Okay, now that's what I was afraid
of. I love you,
okay,
Teddy!
Stop it. Let's be professional, okay? Mr. Myers, from now on.
I love you, Mr. Myers!
Okay. That's inappropriate. I'm drawing the line here, okay?
It's not that inappropriate.
You're in the middle of a shift right now. We've got 10 people waiting in line.
You're sweating.
I have a condition, okay? It started in high school. I've saw tons of specialists. Nobody knows what's happening. Stop it, okay?
I could tell you what's happening. You're falling in love.
No, I'm a happily married man.
Not true. I've seen you at night. Yeah.
What do you mean you've seen me at night?
I've seen you. You get up and you sit in the corner in your chair and you just stare.
Okay, that's creepy. All right?
Is it creepy or is it romantic? Sometimes there's not much of a line between the two.
Okay, can you get back and finish your shift, okay?
Can you get back and finish the shift?
I'm working till 10 o'clock.
Me too.
No, you're not. You've done it 3 today, okay? I'm not going to schedule you for a 14-hour shift like a manager. Nope. Trisha, what are you doing? Nope. Trisha, no. Please.
I kissed your nipple. That was so much worse than letting me kiss your nipples, okay?
Look, don't you want to find a nice guy your own age?
You are my age.
No.
I'm 52.
That can't be right. If that's true, you've held up very well.
Thank you.
Okay, but you seem mid-20s.
Oh, right. I'm 25.
Okay, you inverted the number.
Yes.
Some kind of promotion going on in the parking lot.
Well, I hope it's a lover's quarrel. And I hope she runs away.
Why do you hope that, Esmeralda?
Because sometimes you have a choice when you're young. You can stay or you can go. I drink too many of these goddamn LaCroix and I have a headache.
You know those damn things cause cancer.
I'll believe you because you read 3 newspapers a day.
Right. Everybody led with it today. The Times, the Post, the Journal. Pamplemousse found to cause cancer.
Why would you let me drink so many of these if you knew that?
We're 78. What does it matter?
And if you tell me how old I am again, one more time again.
And there's nothing to be embarrassed about.
I'm not embarrassed.
It's just a fact.
You know what else is a fact? We're married.
Tell me something I don't.
And it's too late.
Too late for what?
To not at least pretend to be in love with each other.
Somebody spilled a drink over there.
All right, that was a really sweet moment. I was putting it all out there, laid it all on the line.
You sure you don't want to take a bite of your sandwich? What's that? Something a little hard? Something a little hard in your sandwich?
Oh my goodness.
Will you marry me all over again?
Yes, I will. I'm putting it on my own finger this time, though. You did it.
And that Uber that's coming back in a half hour is taking us straight to the airport.
We're going to Paris?
Texas.
Yeah. All right, guys, I have a clipboard. You know what that means?
Serious time.
No, not really. I just have really fun news to deliver to you. One of them is that tomorrow night is the opening night of Mad Dash, Curious Comedy's newest sketch review. We're going to be playing for 3 weekends. So opening night is tomorrow at 9:30, and then we're doing another show on the 17th and the 24th, directed by Carla Gagowski, who you just saw.
Yeah!
Yeah! And then on Sunday, if you don't know about it yet, well, hot damn, you're about to know about it. Colin Mockery's in town. Yeah. We're going to be playing at Revolution Hall. Get your tickets if you don't have it yet. It's probably going to sell out. It's going to be amazing. And then speaking of that, we have some gentlemen who will be playing with Mr. Colin Mockery. And they've also been to the Stumptown Improv Festival. They're going to be at the Black and Funny Festival in Minneapolis, Minnesota at the end of the month. It's your headliners. It's Bro Craven!
My moonwalk was okay.
No, you need to be more positive. You need to feel your moonwalk inside of you.
I don't need to be great.
I gave you the same look Joe gave Michael. When he was like, I don't need to be great.
Like before he hit him?
No, I'm not going to hit him.
Well, guys, hold on. Hold on a second. We got to work this up. Are we good?
Yeah, we're good.
Okay.
We're good.
How's everybody doing? Yeah, it's a good start for the show. Yeah? Yeah. No. We're broke, baby.
Yeah.
How are you? Yeah? Yeah? Yeah.
do a little bit better than that. You just kind of, Wimbro Gravy, how you doing? Okay, much better.
I'm Leon.
I'm Eric.
I'm Chris.
So, we like to start off our show with just kind of chatting with y'all a little bit. So, is there anyone out here who has a weird phobia?
Yeah.
Was that up top or down here? Okay. We got a pregnant person phobia.
You're scared of pregnant people.
Well, yeah, they have a tiny alien thing hanging out
in them. Do you consider yourself an alien thing?
Sure.
All right, that's a weird twist.
When did you realize that you had natophobia?
Is that the actual term?
I don't know.
Oh, okay. Just, you sold it well.
That was good.
It was in seventh grade.
Oh, okay. Wow.
Was there an experience particular?
Teacher, pregnancy, it was gross.
A teacher who was like sex ed, or was the teacher pregnant?
No, the teacher was pregnant.
Oh.
Was it your teacher?
Yes.
Oh.
It was traumatic.
Was it like you had a hunch that something was happening, or one day you're just like, what the fuck?
She told us and it was fine until she started showing it.
Oh, she told you before the first, yeah. In the first try? You don't do that.
Do you remember this teacher? Do you remember
the teacher's name? Her students were the first people she told.
Do you remember the teacher's name?
Miss Christensen.
Miss Christensen.
Yes.
And that's you were cool good. With Miss Christensen until she started to show.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Okay. Did she make it through the school year, or did you have a substitute at the end?
She didn't seriously just stop working there, so I'm not sure why.
Okay. Did she stop working there, or did she have maternity leave? In your world, she stopped working. Right.
And what's your name? Can we get your name? Cassidy?
Hi, Cassidy. Okay. Everyone give Cassidy a round of applause.
Cassidy, yeah.
So, do you still have any friends that you communicate with from seventh grade?
Yeah, a few.
Do you all, like, when you're sitting around, just like, after having a few drinks or whatever, just like, look at each other and be like, what the fuck happened with Miss Christensen?
It seems like a huge mystery that we'll never find out.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Are you from? You're from this area, or?
Yeah, I'm in Troutdale, suburbs.
Okay. Great.
All right. Anyone else have a phone? Thank you very much.
Thank you, Cassidy.
Anyone else have anything that they're strangely afraid of?
Sharks.
Okay. Well, let's have a double conversation here.
That's a joke.
We have sharks and whales.
Okay.
Whale sharks.
Sure.
Yeah.
Any sharks.
Okay.
All sharks.
Do you swim in the ocean?
No.
No.
Absolutely not.
Okay. When did you first realize you had this phobia?
I went to Universal Studios when I was like
The Jaws ride?
I had no idea this was gonna happen. And Jaws like happened like right like 3 inches from my face.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, cool, not doing this ever again.
Yeah.
I grew up in Colorado, so it was like super land.
Yeah. So when you were in line for the Jaws ride, you never looked up and looked at any of the posters?
It's a sewer part, and so there's no, they don't tell you anything that's going to happen. Then like, Jaws just comes at you.
But you got in line for Jaws.
No, I got in line for the sewer.
Oh, it was like the studio tour kind of thing. Okay.
Yeah. And the Jaws just pops out of you.
And it scared you. You realize I'm afraid of sharks.
Yeah.
Okay.
That
that's healthy. Okay.
Shark week is the worst week.
Oh, that scares you too.
I can't deal with it.
Okay.
It stresses me out.
Like,
oh, I feel you.
Do you only have one channel?
Got that free Discovery.
Yeah, he's like, just Discovery. Like, Hulu's just Discovery. Okay.
I'm trying to face it, is the thing.
Okay.
You've
and
tried?
Yeah, I'm trying to
fail.
Alright.
And what's your name?
Andre.
Andre.
Everybody give it up for Andre.
Colorado College. What part of Colorado are you from?
Greeley.
Greeley?
Yeah.
Okay. Right. Okay. What's Greeley known for? You know? Like
Cow shit.
Yeah.
Cow shit.
Yeah.
Thank you.
All right.
bullshit?
Yeah.
Is it in Northern Colorado?
Yeah.
I've only been to like a mystical part of Northern Colorado, and they're like, it's gonna smell like shit. And I was like, okay. Yeah, and then it did.
Okay.
That's probably is that where Northern
Colorado, yeah.
Well, there you go. I
Thank
played
you.
Football in Northern Colorado, and it smelled like shit.
Looks like y'all have something in common.
We got Andre. We got Cassidy.
Yeah. Miss Christensen showing pregnancy.
Aliens.
Disappearing suddenly. Shark week, worst week ever.
Seventh grade.
Yeah.
Then we got a lot of stuff. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. We're broke gravy. You hungry, boy?
I could eat.
I just made a big catch on the last trip.
I know. I wish I could have gone with you.
That's all right. Do you want to look?
No, you know I'm scared of salmon.
Do you want to look it in the eye?
No!
It's gonna swim upstream for you. Teddy. Teddy.
Get those omega-3s away from me! It's not funny!
It has to complete its trip before you can eat it.
It's not funny, Dad. You know I fell in the water that one day.
I'm sorry, son. I know you fell that one time.
Hey, Teddy. I'm really happy that we came out here on this date.
It's beautiful.
Yeah.
It's romantic, isn't it?
Yeah, it sure is.
I love the water.
Oh my God, you're so brave. You just reach over the side of
what?
It.
It's not brave, it's just water.
It's not just water.
Look,
there's spirits in the water, Teddy.
Oh my God.
Teddy.
Terry, don't be silly.
No, stop. You're gonna piss them off.
Piss what off?
You're gonna piss off the gods.
Just feel it.
Never put your hands in me again. You're not gonna eat this salmon, son? It's been filleted just like you like it.
Dad, I need to tell you something.
Well, you can tell me anything, son.
Shut your mouth. Never say anything to anybody about him.
Sit down. We'll talk about it over dinner.
Enjoy your supper.
Are you worried about senior year?
I mean, yeah, you know, it's like, am I gonna go to Michigan State or am I gonna go to Colorado? I gotta make a choice.
If I have my way, you'll be a Ram, but that's okay. You do you.
I never told you what happened when
Baby,
I fell
you
in
go
the...
to any school that you want, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Now, I told you I was making salmon. You didn't have to make a full turkey.
Oh, you know how I love my boys to eat.
There'll be plenty of leftovers.
Eat up anything
you can
you don't
take
finish,
some with
take
you.
Take them to college.
To college.
To Colorado
That's
State.
Right. That's right.
Only if you want to, though.
That's right.
Go Rams.
Go Rams.
But I might be a Spartan. I haven't made up my mind yet. Anyways, I didn't tell you what happened when I fell in the water. Terry, it was like she...
It was like what?
Why are you smiling, son?
I'm not...
Keep on smiling. Everything's fine.
The salmon's getting cold. It's gonna cook through. You need to get it while it's still a little raw in the salmon.
Raw.
I'm trying to be brave right now. Listen to me. I don't care about the salmon.
Oh, I'm sorry, Teddy.
What are you doing? No, don't.
I've been holding on to this too long.
Hey, keep on holding on to it. No, you're my best friend. You're the only thing I have going.
I didn't fall in the water.
That's right. You jumped in the water because you wanted to see what the experience was like.
Terry got possessed.
No, don't tell
me. And she picked me up.
Your girlfriend?
Yes, she picked me up and threw me
Damn.
Into the water.
Well, fine. I can see that I'm not wanted here anymore.
And ever since then, this voice has just been following me everywhere I go.
Well, you don't have to worry about that anymore. I'm just gonna go off on my own.
It's a horrible voice. It's like they've been smoking for
the guy and Mrs. Doubtfire?
Although we've come to the
I think they're leaving. I think they're leaving. They're singing Boys to Men.
That sounds like a sign, son. It's because you're graduating. These are just normal tears.
Okay. You can't hear it anymore.
Eat your salmon. That's because you're growing up in front of my eyes. Honey, our boy is growing up. He's gonna be a ram.
Or a Spartan. I haven't made up my mind.
But if you're a ram, you'll be closer to home.
Oh, yes, you will. I just went outside and polished your bright green ram. That's right, I got you a Dodge Ram, baby. Mm-hmm. You guys got me a car?
Happy early birthday, son.
Happy birthday. Oh, can I go look?
Oh, of course.
Go right ahead. I still don't know what school I'm going to, but... He's going to Colorado He's going to Colorado.
We did good, Marjorie.
Oh, we sure did.
This reminds me of... when we met in college.
Oh, that was so long ago.
Oh, you're being modest, Marjorie. Being modest.
Oh, come on. It was barely us finishing school at that time.
Oh, we finished plenty.
You did!
Well, I have your results, and congratulations. You are pregnant.
Yay!
Sorry, this wasn't. Oh, this wasn't planned.
Oh, sweetheart, I invested in the aquarium. Our aquarium's gonna be great. I bought our first hammerhead. Oh my goodness! We got the tank. I've got like a month's worth of food. We just gotta start getting people in the door. We'll get people in the door. They'll enjoy. I named them Alfonso.
Oh, we just need to get one. We need to get that first.
Look at Alfonso, look at how glorious he is.
Oh my,
wow.
You know, Alfonso takes up a lot of room.
Watch.
About the same amount of room as the nursery would take up.
Oh, like a garden?
Yes.
I'm just gonna feed him, do my. Just.
Oh. Wow, that.
Alfonso, so.
It's. Wow, it's sure a good thing we don't have any kids, right? That would be dangerous.
Oh, you mean like baby goats?
Yes. Yes.
Oh, like, yeah, no,
yes,
that's.
Baby goats.
No one likes petting zoos anymore.
No.
It's all about amphibians and land.
Can I?
Jason.
You gotta tell him. You're gonna start showing soon.
It's just I don't know how he'll react.
What does it matter? You have to tell him.
Why?
Because presumably
he's
gonna.
You'll find out in 6 months.
But he'll freak out.
I'll go away for a while and just come back with a baby.
You think that's a better solution?
Well, then he can't freak out. It's impossible to freak out around a baby.
I know you talked about us working on our figures, so a couple of salads.
Thank you. I've been very hungry recently, and this salad looks so nourishing and healthy. You know, I have, the girls and I from the sorority are going to be meeting back up again, having our 2.5-year reunion.
Oh.
Yeah, we're going to the Florida Keys.
Mm-hmm. Wait,
so I'll be gone for...
You're going to the Florida Keys? You
going
didn't
to
tell
Florida
me?
Keys. It's just a girls' trip, so I'm going to be gone for like 2 weeks max.
But the animals down there could be perfect. I just bought a second tank.
I
know you said not to, but there was a really good deal on a second tank.
We are running out of room. We're running out of room. We're running out of room, honey. We had a 4-bedroom house. We now sleep in the living room because you have a shark tank, you have a whale tank, you have a fucking seahorse tank. I don't understand how one man can have 10 million seahorses. Do you know how hard it is to take care
watching the male seahorse and how they take care of their children, I feel like I have some ideas.
Oh, I'm sorry, it's feeding time for Esmeraldo. So majestic and sweet. And thank you for letting me just incorporate it in the whole house. It's really great having such a big tank. Oh, you really took down that salad, didn't you? Sweetie, what? Hey, where are you trying to? Hey, what's the matter? I just feel cornered in this relationship. This house isn't big enough for the three of us.
For the three of who?
I shouldn't have invested in that kangaroo. That doesn't fit the motif, I'm sorry.
It's okay, maybe our baby can sleep in the kangaroo.
Well, welcome to the Colorado Pregnancy Farm. Yep. We got lots of young ladies here who are between 4 and 8 months. We got a lot of things to do on this farm. That there is Betty Lou.
Hi.
She's about 7 and a half.
Feel like 12.
Betty Lou.
It gets better though, right? Right?
Oh, no. Yeah, but you know, the work here is light. Got a lot of cows over here. We're gonna milk a lot of cows. You just gotta watch out for all the cow shit. You know, watch where you're walking.
You get used to the smell in a minute.
Can I get you some water or maybe a towel to wipe off the sweat?
That all makes me nauseous.
Yep.
Towels make you nauseous? Yeah.
Cows make me nauseous. Cows make me nauseous. Manure makes me nauseous. Water makes me nauseous.
Whoa.
You know those little toothpicks that are kind of like mini flosses?
Yeah,
those make
me
nauseous.
I was just about to give you a toothpick.
I have Andy's Mint.
Oh, I love Andy's Mint.
They're delicious, and I can't have them anymore. I think they're ruined for me forever.
That's a goddamn shame. I love them.
You ever driven like a
1962 Porsche?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Chucking. I'm just chucking.
Well, this conversation.
Hold on.
Uh-oh.
I don't, but,
Oh, I'm sorry. That was just.
Anyways, if you have any questions, I'm located about 3 miles north in the house on the hill.
All right, just one quick question. Do I have a room here? Is there someplace I can put my bags, or do we all just sleep standing up?
Of course, you don't sleep standing up. That's a ridiculous statement. Okay. There's a house over there. It holds 24 of you pregnant women. Exactly 24. There are bunk beds.
Okay.
You are, how far along are you?
I'm 4 and a half months.
Oh, so you'll get the top. The further along you are, the lower you must sleep.
Safety first. That makes sense. Okay.
Okay, so
right.
I'm gonna go.
Thanks, Billy.
Thank you.
You got it.
Thank you, Billy.
Oh, I see what you're doing now.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna get on my horse. Been standing here the whole time. Quietly. I trained it that way.
Why don't you drive your car that's sitting right there?
Name's Smokey.
Don't worry about the car.
Okay.
He's not gonna. He pretends it ain't there, but it's
okay.
Thank you. Okay, so.
Bye, Billy.
Ladies.
All right.
Man.
Takes a while to get out of here.
Hi. Hi.
Did you leave or did you get left?
Oh, I left. I left.
Wow.
I couldn't tell my husband I was pregnant.
Wow.
Because I... He loves collecting things. And he was so happy. And I couldn't face it to tell him that we were having a child.
Do
Do you think you'd want to collect a child?
Excuse me. My name's Miss Christensen.
Oh, hello.
Do you know where I'm supposed to go?
No, I think just right here.
Everyone's welcome here as long as you're at least 2 months along.
Oh, yes, I'm 5 months along, and I had to leave.
Oh, you couldn't even tell.
Thank
you.
Thank you for saying that, because
skeleton.
Well, I'm a teacher, and I teach this horrible young girl, and every time I would come in class, she would start crying, so
I used to be a member of the PTA, and there was a horrible young girl that we would talk about all the time as well.
You know, back in my old life as an astronaut.
Wow.
I know. They kick you out right away as soon as they find out you're pregnant.
Well, those spacesuits aren't too stretchy.
It's not. It's just a boys' club. It's just a big boys' club.
Yeah,
but there was one particular person with an androgynous name who always messed with me.
Huh.
Let's all try and say our person's name at the same time.
Oh, that's a fun game. I'm starting to like this pregnancy farm.
Let me put my bags back down.
One,
two,
three.
Cassidy!
Oh my god!
That's gotta be the worst person that there is.
On the count of three, let's all say her last name.
Okay.
One.
Hold on a second. Why are we doing that?
It seems like a stretch.
But it could be interesting if it all works out. I'm sorry, I'm new to this pregnancy thing.
It just felt so good when we all said the first thing.
Imagine how good it would be to say the second. I'm gonna go check into my bunk.
Oh, I'll follow you.
Oh, that sounds wonderful.
I'm just gonna lay here.
Oh, okay. Is... It smells awful.
Oh, it's terrible.
That book's mine.
Hi.
Y'all new?
My name is Miss Christensen.
I don't care. Well, then I won't say my name since I haven't said it yet anyway.
Y'all must be new around here.
Yes, we covered. Yes.
I'm a teacher. I teach the
same. I don't care.
This is a pregnancy farm, right? Not a prison.
It's starting to seem like one and the same.
No one ever asks how the baby feels.
How's the baby?
Are you pregnant?
The baby's in prison for 9 months, ain't it? You ever think about that? When you didn't pull out?
I don't think that's my job.
Did you just say when she didn't pull out?
I could have backed off, but
that's really personal.
Hold on. You mean to tell me that you let the man do the sex to you?
Well, I am.
What kind of sissy ass ladies is you?
I'm no sissy.
I'm not a sissy either.
And yet, there you are, getting pregnant.
You're pregnant too.
Because I chose to be.
I chose to be too. The only reason I'm here is because of a horrible monster named Cassidy!
Don't you dare say my name out loud. Is there something wrong with my name?
No.
I didn't think so. Now, fluff my pillow. You fluff my baby's pillow.
Has your baby been born on?
Tonight.
How do you know your baby's gonna be born tonight?
Because I'm fucking Dolly. I don't need no ice block. Is there some bunny, fresh meat?
15,000 years.
This is good. This is good. This is a test. This is what we
this
have.
This is a test. I'm Jesus.
Okay.
What are you doing?
I'm just being here with you.
Are you a doula? You my doula?
No, but I've read magazines. I've read magazines and I know.
She done read a magazine.
I know what to expect.
My best friend is a doula.
Oh, then you should be down here.
No. I just said my best friend is a doula. Are you really dilated?
This ain't part of my birth plan either way. And yes, I'm dilated.
Where are you from?
Do you want us to call the field master and have him come out here for you?
I'm from Tualatin, suburb.
And I don't think he's a field master. That doesn't sound right. I think he just is the owner of the pregnancy farm.
Oh.
Oh, you are dilated. You are, oh. Yes.
Yeah, I'm proud of that. Don't worry about it.
Why are you so hostile? You're about to give birth and that's a beautiful thing. Why are you?
You
haven't
been pregnant for 10 months? 10 months?
That's. No, I have not.
Well, then don't tell me how to live.
You've been pregnant for 10 months?
Yes. Give me that lemonade over there.
I got the lemonade.
Just get the lemonade.
You want ice in it?
Can we speed this up?
Of course you want ice in it. That was a stupid question.
I just don't think that anyone should have to be pregnant for so long.
Why are you pregnant if you didn't choose to be?
Because I love my husband.
Then why aren't you with him?
Because I want him to be happy, and I keep asking that same question. Every time anyone asks.
Does he know you're pregnant?
No.
Then how do you know he wouldn't be happy?
Wait a minute.
Yeah.
You didn't run away because of a horrible child?
No.
You're just scared to tell your husband?
No, he likes sharks, and
it sounds like y'all got a communication problem. They even your bags. They his cheap bags. I don't
care whose bags they are.
You know, I hate to say it, but I agree with Cassidy.
I'm gonna get my husband back.
I think you should get your husband
back. I'm gonna get my husband back.
And I'll help Cassidy's give birth.
I feel like a female seahorse.
Why didn't you tell me?
Because I didn't want to ruin your happiness. This is the happiest thing you could have ever told me. I've had an empty tank waiting the whole time.
Comedy, super appreciated. We'll see you tomorrow night.